Prime Minister Prodi, it's my pleasure and honor to welcome you to the Equine Year School.
It's my pleasure.
We're truly delighted to have you here, and we're very grateful that you've agreed to do this interview. As you know, the European Union has faced some serious crises in recent years, the near collapse of the euro, the Ukraine crisis, and now, of course, the migrant crisis. So my question to you is that were these all accidents that could not have been prevented? Or could good planning and wise leadership have helped to prevent some of this crisis from happening in Europe?
Well, this, from some point of view, they were clear, you know, that immigration, we have no level of birth in Europe, a pressure from Europe, you must for the part in politics, you never afford the difficult problem before that they hit you. And so, in theory, you are right. In real terms, everybody wants to delay, also because European politicians are always before an election.
Yes.
And so now, this is a typical case in which you don't want to tackle difficult problems, and you delay.
That's true, and that's true in democracies. Politicians worry more about getting re-elected than long-term challenges. But looking ahead now, and especially at the future of the EU, if the EU is going to remain a strong organization, what are the reforms that the EU needs to make today to ensure that it remains strong and vibrant in years to come?
Oh, very simple. The reform is to make the EU, because now it's a bread half-baked.
It's a half-baked cake.
Yeah. Yes. Half-baked cake, you know. We have the euro, and that is fine, but not the budget agreement or the financial agreement necessary to keep it on.
That's right.
When I asked, when I told that to the Chancellor Kohl, the German Chancellor, he was correct. He told me, look, now we did it. Rome was not done in one day. But now it's irreversible, and step by step, we shall build all the other things. But then we have the years of fear. Fear of immigrants, fear for the economic crisis,
yes.
And the government became national. This is the story. We have, so we went back in the last 10 years.
Yes. So are you looking ahead? Are you optimistic or pessimistic about Europe?
If you look at the experience, I am optimistic in the sense that Europe always went on the, let's say, on the fringe.
On the edge of cliff, but it comes back.
Come back. You know, we had years in which they were called the time of the empty chair, in which even France was not participating to the European meeting, then,
yes.
But would be a different Europe.
Yeah, it would be a different Europe. But you know, in times like this, people always ask themselves, why don't we have strong leaders like the ones we used to have in the past? So the question I have, you mentioned Chancellor Kohl, for example. I think he'll be regarded as one of the great leaders of Germany, I'm sure. So from your experience, who are the strong leaders that you have met and that you would say these are truly impressive world leaders I've met in my lifetime?
Among the Europeans?
Europeans or world leaders?
On the Europeans, probably the man you mentioned before, you know, Chancellor Kohl, it was, from some point of view, very strange, because it was like, you know, a simple guy, you know, but this was his virtue. He was going on, till arriving to the point in which you were obliged to say yes or no. You know, he was absolutely unintellectual, but going to the... And I think in my life I found that this is the most important virtue for a businessman and for a politician. Let's say, when you have to take decision, you go to the essence, yes or no. And Kohl was bringing me, when we had a conversation, pop, 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 yes or no. And this was for me impressive. Look, staying on principle, I mean, you know, for example, when we had to start with the euro, I remember a conversation that I want the euro, even if the Germans don't want it.
Just a consider to you. Wow.
My consider don't want it. I want the euro for two reasons. First of all, because my brother died in the war. Incredible, you know. Second, and then he repeated Thomas Mann phrase, because I want a European Germany, and not a German Europe. And you know that he simplified two political reasons because I want the euro. Then I write the problem of the budget, and I suppose, look, this will come. This will come. But now, yes or no?
Yeah, I must say, this shows how far-sighted Chancellor Kohl was. I actually accompanied Prime Minister Lee Kuan Yew when he went to call on Chancellor Kohl once, and I remember Mr. Lee Kuan Yew was very impressed by him. But here today, as you know, we are in the Lee Kuan Yew school, and many students coming here aspire to become leaders. So if you were to give young people coming to study at the Lee Kuan Yew school some advice for their future careers, what are the three things or pieces of advice you would give to them?
May I repeat to your question with the, tell you the last, my last meeting with the Lee Kuan Yew?
Lee Kuan Yew? Oh, good. Tell us about your last meeting with the Lee Kuan Yew.
I came here and I thought, President, how beautiful is Singapore? It's full of flowers. And he told me, like, that's true, it's full of flowers, because I send my expert everywhere in the equatorial areas. They came with 1,800 species different. 800 went well. And now we have flowers all the days of the year. But remember that now our bees, because of that, they don't make any more any honey. And so to the young people, have to remember, look, sacrifice, be constant, because otherwise you don't make honey. This is what I learned here in my last visit in Singapore.
So sacrifice.
And we added, we bought bees from Italy. They did only for 2 years, and then they stopped it. So this was for me a lesson that when you run a complex society, politics, business, you have to give always incentives. Mm-hmm. Always incentives. If you have flowers, always you don't produce bees.
That's true. So they're year-round and there's no need to produce honey. That's a very important point, because there's a sense that if you have too much, you give up trying. So in some ways, it's better off not to have too much and to continue to struggle in your life.
When you tell this with this idea of flowers and bees,
people understand.
You will never forget. You will never forget. So I shall never forget Singapore.
That's right. Well, Mr. Lee Kuan Yew was a very wise man. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure for me.